gentlemen, welcome to Real Talk with Saieed Ali. I am your host, Saeed. Remember, we are live on Synergy Network viewers. Every night, I tell you the same. Go on your Facebook account, pick up your phone, pick up your tablet, go by your computer. Go on your Facebook account, type Real Talk with Saeed Ali, like and share, viewers. The reason why I ask you to do this is for those of you who do not or cannot look at us from 7 to 8 p.m. on our live program, will be able to see us live on Facebook. Share it, Trinidad and Tobago. We are the number one current affairs program in this country. Remember that. So viewers, as we start up our program tonight, remember, like I said on a previous night, Real Talk is giving you 4% on fixed deposit. Now, here is where it gets better. As long as you open a fixed deposit account with us, we are giving you the interest up front. So remember that, viewers. Remember that. You are getting your interest up front instead of having to wait 3, 4, 5 years. You're getting it up front while your money is secured. But remember, do not break your fixed deposit. There are penalties. Just like any other financial institution, there are penalties. So viewers, I am proud to say to you tonight, come be a member of Real Talk Credit Union. Buy shares, open a fixed deposit, open a savings account for you and your children. I am pleased to say that to you, Trinidad and Tobago. And in saying this, I am going to tell you this. I am here to change the way the banking sector operates in Trinidad and Tobago. Why? By the first implementation of, we are giving you your interest up front once you sign on with us on a fixed deposit. Nowhere in Trinidad and Tobago, no credit union, no banks is giving you that. None. Go look, check for yourself. And I am matching any fixed deposit that your credit union or your bank is given. You want to see growth for your money? Trust me, I know how to make your money work for you. Trust me. Real Talk Finance and Investment is in Guyana. Real Talk Credit Union will be in Guyana shortly. So remember that, viewers, I am here to lead while others follow. So as we go to our program tonight, Minister of Finance Colin Mumbert has responded to reports and speculation regarding the new $100 bill due to be released by the central bank later this year. You see, as I talk about it, you see what's happening? Now, the last 5 years, the new polymer $100 bill cost Trinidad and Tobago $78.77 million. Are we going to spend the same money now to introduce a new $100 bill that was... Last 5 years ago, we had a new bill. 5 years up the road, you want to introduce a new $100 bill? Who is making money from this? Who is benefiting from this transaction? Who? But it is obvious that no minister or nobody would come out and say, well, you know what, boy, I'm getting a little something on inside. Nobody will come out and say that. Why are we going to introduce a new $100 bill by December month, when the government is thinking of going cashless, a cashless society? Ola, explain this for me now. So this is what I want Colin Mumbert now, and the ministers, or the line ministers, everybody in the finance department, in the government, answer that. We want to digitalize. Digitalize the financial sector. We want to go cashless with the financial sector, but we're implementing a new $100 bill. 5 years ago, $78.77 million we spent to introduce a new $100 bill. 5 years up the road, how much money we are to spend now to introduce a new $100 bill? Could the governor of Central Bank come out and say, why are we doing this? Because every ministry, you always hear the head minister saying, Well, you know, we don't have money and we under budget and we can't fix this, but we're going and spend excessive amount of money to introduce a new $100 bill. Why? Why? In a post on Twitter, Mr. Imbert said, a recent news article has led to uninformed commentary. He said the central bank is simply introducing new $100 bills to improve the security features on the note. Both old and new will be legal tender. According to the report, the new bills will be issued in November 2024. And they introduce the polymer bill, and they introduce a see-through part of the bill. They have a little plastic window, see-through window, new bills, new security features, and they still counterfeit the $100 bill. After ministers came out and said they cannot do it, not long after fake $100 polymer note that is circulated. You don't want to give up tonight, boy. But nevertheless. So imagine this, eh? Can central bank, let me tell you something, don't do like what you're doing 5 years back. Could the central bank governor, or could Colin Imbert, come out and tell Trinidad and Tobago how much it is going to cost to bring this new $100 bill on stream? Can the Ministry of Finance, somebody in the Ministry of Finance, come out and tell us that? Because I go tell you something, according to Prime Minister, we never have money. We never have money to fix schools, to buy machinery in the hospital. Postal, we're going on with postal service. We're going on with back pay for police. What's going on with that? We never have money, but we're going to waste money to introduce new security on what, a $100 bill that they recently brought out? No, common sense will tell you you're wasting money. Repair the schools, fix the roads. Waste the money there. But hear this now, switching gears. Attorney General Regional Amo have stated that he is going ahead with the state case against Brent Thomas, noting that the recent decision by the Barbados government to accept liability in a lawsuit involving his extradition from that island to TNT in 2022 has no impact on the case against him in Trinidad. Amo said he also had every confidence that Attorney General of Barbados, Dale Marshall, SC, was acting in the best interest of Barbados. But he said he had no intention of offering his opinion on the matter. He was responding to reports that the Barbados government had accepted liability in the matter after Thomas sued over his forced 2022 deportation from the country. Thomas is also seeking information on who authorized the action against him on both the Barbados and TNT side. After the news out of Barbados broke, former Commissioner of Police Gary Griffith claimed that the truth of the government's involvement in the controversial 2022 arrest of Thomas in Barbados will soon be revealed. So who called the shots? That is what we want to find. So Trinidad and Tobago, everybody talking about the demerit points in Trinidad and Tobago, the unnecessary roadblocks over the Easter weekend. Everyone has complained about it. And everyone has been complaining about it, especially the demerit point. Now, I want to ask the minister or the ministry department in licensing, is it legal Now listen to this. Before I go there, recently, in the licensing office, if you had an unpaid ticket and you transfer your vehicle, the unpaid ticket was preventing a transfer of that vehicle. I get a ticket, I didn't pay it, and I go to sell Nav in my car. According to the licensing office, I cannot transfer the car until I pay my ticket. They went to court. The court found that action illegal. Illegal. The licensing department, they lost that case because the court found it illegal action. And it's become an illegal act. So if I have a ticket and I decide to sell my car, we could go ahead now and do the transaction. So now I want to ask the licensing department, the head of licensing department, why did you all implement a demerit point system? What is that actually proven in Trinidad and Tobago? What? Transport Commissioner Clive Clark have stated that motorists are caught driving vehicles that are not inspected could face a fine of $2,000 and 6 demerit points. So I want to ask Clive now, why demerit points? Tell me, why demerit points? Now, there are government vehicles that have bad tire, lights not working, they could barely see the number plate. Are they paying penalty fees, Clark? Or is it only the citizens of Trinidad and Tobago have to pay that with their private vehicle and their transport vehicle? So the government vehicle now have no part to play in that. Because that is some police vehicle on the road. Imagine them stopping and you could run into them. Imagine them driving along the road and you can't even make out their number plate. Some of them, their lights hanging down. Everybody in Trinidad and Tobago who is on the road driving does notice these things. Now, what is Clive now saying about that? I'm putting you on the spot. The demerit point system, what is that to prove? What is that to prove? You give a man 6 demerit points if you don't have an inspection sticker. Is that helping, Clive? Tonight, I'm putting you on the spot because I will tell you something. It is ridiculous. Imagine I want to sell my car, I got a ticket, and I can't transfer my car because of a bloody hell ticket. What does the ticket have to do with me transferring my car, Clyde? Let me tell you something. You see, you and your whole team up there, all you need to revamp the whole license office. Because you coming up with ideas that are not making sense. It's not making sense. And like you, apparently like you need an extra pair of glasses to see. An extra pair. He stated that the fine is in accordance with the Motor Vehicle Road Inspection Act. Or the Motor Vehicle and Road Traffic Act. Now let's listen to this man.
Well, inspection it's a fixed penalty offense. Mm-hmm. So we're looking at $2,000 and as well as 6 demerit points.
Six demerit points.
Yeah. Wow. So if you for some reason you continue to drive a vehicle and it's not inspected, you could rack up quite easily 12 demerit points and you find yourself into 6 months possible suspension.
This man making any sense at all? How much company vehicles that have on the road? All right, let me pause company vehicle. How much government vehicles that have on the road, Clyde, that is unfit for the damn road? How much? How much? You sit on in that chair proud. 6 demerit point. You could easily be disqualified. You putting food on them table? I'm asking you a question. You putting food on them table when they reach the maximum demerit point? Is foolish thinking like these, is foolish legislation and laws like this, this cause robbery in Trinidad and Tobago? Take what I'm telling all you. You want to implement a system to make money for the government, but the thing is, all that system ain't even working. You can tell me a man driving a police vehicle or a government vehicle, and he gets stopped. The indicator ain't working, the bulb ain't working, you have no reverse light, you could barely see the number plate, and then getting to go free. A man like me, 2 points for that. 3 points for this. With the vehicle 9-6, you get 6 points. When they make up 12 points now, what going on with me? Who put in food on my chair and table? Oh, Saeed, well, you know, you got to go on next work. How the hell I go get on next work when my license is spent? How am I going to get on next work now, driving, and my license is spent? Clive, let me tell you something. I don't care what you say, you know. But to be honest with you, this demerit point system putting people home. And when people go home now from driving and they care what, where they going and do, Clyde, come on, tell me, open your mouth. Open your proud mouth. I said that nonsense in license office. Demerit point for what? For what, Clyde? You want to issue something to make money for the government, but are they implementing the damn thing bad? Are they implementing a set of nonsense? When you take drivers off the street, if that part of your brain is working, let me tell you something. When you take drivers off the street, when they hit 12 demerit point, you think all they're going to make money? All their revenue stream will cut down instead I go up. All they ever think about that? So Clyde, here, what were you to do? You see, you and your team, I talking bold and brave, you know, me don't care what they're saying, you know, because you implement a demerit point system that will stop all that from charging a man for a blow bulb. If I get suspended, I can't drive. How are they going to make money from me? You clown. The whole of licensing department needs to review the demerit point system. Review it. If I want to make money for the government, come up with something different. But when I get suspended and I home, and I can't get next driving work to my family, what you think I going and do? Clyde, what you think I going and do? I accustomed driving. Driving is my thing. Driving, I'm making money with my family. I work in taxi, I work in PH as a truck driver. And when you put me out of a job now with a silly thing, a stupid dotage thing, as a demerit point system, what's going to happen? You lost the avenue of making thousands of dollars from me. You know why? You want to know why, Clyde? Because going down the road, my bulb could blow and a police could stop me and get my ticket. But when I'm home now, me are driving nothing while I'm making. You see, boy, let me tell you something, eh? It is how people who want to implementing for the government to make money. But instead of causing it to go up, they're causing it to crash. Let me just use a figure. Let me say 5,000 drivers get suspended. That is 5,000 drivers or a cannot give ticket. Make that make sense now, Clyde. You and your team who come up with this idea, make that make sense. The damn road they're fixing in Trinidad and Tobago is your brakes in pothole, you end up hitting somebody while your brakes in a pothole. Clyde, you can't go to Rohan Sinanan and tell Rohan, well, you know what, boy? In order for me to make money, we have to fix something. You put a new tire today, go down in a pothole at bend tomorrow. The rim bend, the shock bend too. The ball joint fall out. But allow the charge man now for a tire that cut him. You think the tire got cut for himself? Yes or no, Clyde? You have to go down in a hole to bend the tire for the alignment to go out, for the tire to cut bad. And you in transport? Who pick you to be in transport? Common sense you don't have. Common sense. Commissioner Clark reiterated that there is no motorum in inspection sticker at this point in time, and encouraged drivers to visit testing station and have their vehicle inspected to ensure it meets the criteria for what is required by law.
My concern as commissioner is not so much the points and the tickets. You know, it bothers me when I go on the outside and we have to issue an inspection fixed penalty notice. And why? It is because though we are not in a moratorium at this point in time. And if I am a concerned driver, I will ensure my vehicle actually reaches what meets the criteria for what is required by law, right? Ensuring inspection is in place. And therefore, I encourage persons to visit the testing stations where necessary. Come to the licensing office if you have a goods vehicle or a taxi and get your vehicle inspected.
Inspection is not the problem, Clyde. Inspection is not the problem. Half of the government vehicle are even inspected. Half of the government vehicle have bad tire. Half of the government vehicle, they bulb, their headlight, their mirror ain't working. But you coming down now to implement the merit point system? All you want to make money for the government home, for the government while sending drivers home? And while drivers home now, think so damn hard, they can't go work, they come out and commit a crime now, police can't catch them. Police can't catch them. Because the police ain't nowhere to go and start to look. So all that make it make sense. Make it make sense, Clyde. Come out and tell the public. You see, just how you come out and you sit down there, come out and tell the public the real meaning of the merit point system. Suspend a driver. You suspend a driver, he go home, he can't drive. What he going and do? What he going and do? The man working in a company 20 years now, you give a driver a ticket now for the company fault. What a celeb. Make it make sense, Clyde. You're smart, make that make sense. Call her good night.
Saeed, pleasant good night.
Good night to you, my dear.
Saeed, the transport commissioner sit and cross his legs comfortable and say, come in to license in with your H vehicle and your goods vehicle. I wonder if they're doing it for free. The way he talking, the numeric points. Imagine you driving a company vehicle. And when the vehicle get points, it ain't going on the company owner's permit. It going on your permit.
Correct.
You have to talk that. When you talk, the boss man telling you, well, if you ain't want to drive the vehicle, then you have to go home, you can't work, and you won't get paid. I wonder if Clive Clark going to feed the people children. Eh? All this sort of numeric points stupidness. Eh? It's only pressure these people. Eh? Come in, look at the time of the year you talking about coming and inspect vehicle. Where people getting money? The year now starts. Nobody getting an increase in the salary side across the board. Private or government, worse yet. Eh? Plenty vehicles on the road without an inspection. They inspect last year. Oh God, give the people a chance. People have to eat. They have their children to send to school. Just now, them children who write SCSI, there's thousands of dollars to register in their new schools. Books, book price, uniform price. Why you coming out just so and just rock back and calling shots and putting people under more pressure? Then all you will come out on the street now and start to give ticket like rain because people's vehicle. We now hit in April month. Give people a chance to catch themselves for the year now. Eh? You see, all they're doing from the government go back is to pressure poor people in this place. And you know, people are waking up, eh, Saeed? They're not waking up and seeing. You hear exactly what's going on in this country. Thank you, Saeed.
Thank you, my friend. So, viewers, I want to let you listen to this. Eh? Watch this. Eh? care of a driver and any passenger 17 years and over to wear a seatbelt while a vehicle is in motion, the Motor Vehicle Traffic Act, Chapter 48.50, Section 43C1, is $1,000 penalty and 4 demerit points. Driving a vehicle with a child in the front seat who is 5 years and under, you're paying $1,000 and 4 demerit points. Using a motor vehicle with the windscreen or any window fitted glass so tinted, treated or darkened as to obscure the view of the inside of the vehicle from the outside is $2,000, and them I had no demerit point for that. No demerit point. Driving a driving while disqualified from holding or obtaining a driver's permit, you have 14 demerit points. The man ain't had no license. They catch him driving and they give him 14 demerit points. You can tell me what kind of clown act is this? What purpose is the point serving? You're holding all the roadblocks, all well and good. You're inspecting vehicle, all well and good. But the demerit point system in Trinidad and Tobago will cause people to start robbing. Because work done hard in Trinidad and Tobago, cost of living so damn high. Goods vehicle carrying excessive weight is a $750 fine and 3 demerit point. Imagine you loading up a sand truck. What your clumsy them is, eh? You loading up a sand truck or you loading a gravel truck and you ain't know how much boulders, Clyde, you know how much boulders to put in a dumper truck? I want to ask you a question on national television. Do you know how much boulders it take to fill a dump truck? No, you don't know that. You's not the backhoe man. How will it be so foolish? That penalty is $750 and 3 demerit points. What does the demerit point have to do with it? Huh? How the truck man gonna know the weight of the vehicle? Oh, look, come on, man. Make it make sense, now, man. You have a normal van. You're toting some market goods in it. You go down to a market man who hustling in the market whole night and whole day. You gonna give him 3 demerit points, Clyde? Make it make sense, now, man, Clyde, man. Don't be a big man. Don't be the head of licensing office. And you can't give me an answer. No, don't be so clumsy, now, man. Don't be so clumsy, now, man. That is madness. Everybody, let me tell you something. Have people who are afraid to talk about it. But I ain't afraid, you know. I ain't afraid. Because what you're trying to do, Clyde, is to put a driver out of a job. All this was a fixed crime in Trinidad. All they're implementing ways for man to rob. Call a good night.
Saieed, great program as usual, man. You're really standing up for the citizens of this country, you know, because people are voiceless, right? And you have fellas like the Transport Commissioner talking this stupidness, right? Before he advised the government and this no good who legalized thieving in this country. That is legalized thieving, you know. That vehicle inspection, right? That law is to ensure your vehicle is roadworthy. If your vehicle not roadworthy, how the hell it could be on the road, eh? So the Transport Commissioner couldn't advise him. It's a legal way to thief. And the Transport Commissioner and his officers go out and implement the thieving because they're going out and ticket the citizens of this country who they have to live amongst and live with, ticket the citizens of this country for a crack on the windscreen, a bridge light and all of these kind of things. Mr. Said, you standing up for the citizens of the country. Nobody is talking about this, you know. What are you talking about here tonight? This is a very important topic, you know. If I had money, those laws can't stand up in a court, you know. We country, you know what this country needs? When the transport commissioner's men go there, you see what has happened in Afghanistan and Iraq and all of these places? I ain't inciting violence, but they have to be emancipated. You want to bet the stop all of this stupidness that is happening in this country? Thank you, Mr. Saeed. Eid Mubarak to you, your staff, and your family. Keep up the great work.
Thank you, my friend. So I have some information for you tonight. Since yesterday, I'm planning this, eh? Since yesterday. Now, the merit point system will stay on your record for a maximum of 2 years. Once 2 consecutive years have passed, without the driver accumulating additional demerit points, these points will automatically be removed from his or her driver's record. If the driver reaches a maximum threshold of demerit points, according to the law, he or she can be disqualified from driving for a specific period for the purpose of administering demerit point and disqualifying periods. There is a distinction between. Between what? Well, is that sort of madness all creating? All of making sure people, all of implement that system to make sure that people lose their license? That is what they're doing. The merit points of an experienced driver are accumulated as following. The merit points accumulated within 3 years. Now listen to this. 10 years or more, but less than 14. Suspended period is 6 months. 14 months or more, but less than 20, you're disqualified for 1 year. 20 or more, you're disqualified for 2 years. How are demerit points calculated for newly licensed driver or provisional permit? Demerit points accumulated within 12 months from the date of issue. 7 or more demerit points against suspension for 1 year. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. I buy a car for my son. He now get his license. Under 1 year, he go into work. The ball blow while going down the road. He get the merit point for the ball blow. Clyde, does that make sense? Boy, hey, let me tell you something. Instead of all I get smarter, like, all I get more what? Foolish? Eh? Let me tell you something. It's how nobody end up before the magistrate with this, you know. It's how nobody, you know. Because to help my God, if one of my friends or family get caught up with his 12 demerit points, I going in court with them. And I will ask the judge to ask the commissioner of the licensing office, what is the purpose of the demerit points? Why the hell you giving me a demerit point for a blow light, or for a bent tire, or for a tinted glass, or for my headlight not working? What the hell does demerit point have to do with it? What the hell, Clyde, tell me? Come out and explain to the citizens the reason for demerit points. A ball blow and I gain demerit points? Boy, that the most stupidest thing I ever hear. And that is the most dunciest idea all you could choose to bring out in license office. The most stupidest thing, the most dunciest head thing all you could bring out. Well, good night.
Good night, Mr. Saeed. How are you going, man?
I good. I just trying to get the commissioner of license to make sense out of this for me.
Saeed, let me tell you something. This is the only country where government is make criminals out of innocent law-abiding citizens. You see the same thing here? Where they're charging people and taking out demerit points, and then after one stage it leads to the next, where you could end up in prison for a simple losing your license, and then you take a chance and you drive a vehicle and you end up now with a suspended license and you want to face jail time. That is where a government is creating criminals out of its law-abiding citizen, and a simple scenario to draw to show how dotish these people is in government. You charging a man for not wearing a seatbelt inside of a car, which is protected by the body when you sit down inside the car. But you have people driving on motorcycle without any seatbelt, and that's a vehicle too. And if they're transporting a passenger on this, the person just hugging you up now, and two only without seatbelt on a motorcycle going on the highway 100 kilometers per hour with no seatbelt. So you seen somebody on a motorcycle without seatbelt flying on the highway, that is okay. The law can charge them because there are no seatbelt. But you inside your vehicle, unprotected, and get charged for not wearing a seatbelt. That is how dotish this country is. And look, yesterday, a woman got killed down Gasparillo there on the highway because the vehicle leave one side of the road and went and crashed and the lady died. Now, you providing a highway for citizens to drive on that killing you. You understand? The family of this person was supposed to take the Ministry of Works and Transport to court for involuntary manslaughter because you telling me, make sure your vehicle in perfect working condition, but you're giving us a highway now where at any point in time, you can lose your life on that highway. Let that make it make sense. That is a tell you how dotish. And people in this country have to wake up, go and challenge them in court. Because you can't tell me, I have a perfectly well-organized vehicle. Everything is up to mark. And a man run across from one side of the highway, which supposed to have a barrication because you don't know when you can lose control of a vehicle. A mechanical device could malfunction at any time and come across your highway now, which happened on many occasions and kill people. That is the fault of the Ministry of Works.
Hey,
they're supposed to be facing a court matter for the situation and every other person who loses their life on the highway because cars leave one side of the highway and end up on the other side. Killing somebody. Have a good night, Mr. Saeed, and Eid Mubarak to you and your family. Take care, man.
Thank you, my friend. Let me tell you something. This point system in Trinidad is ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Let me tell you something. When this system implemented, I rock back and I hear, let me hear what the public going on say. You know, nobody here say nothing? Nobody here say nothing? Let me tell you something. I have an MP300. New model, Nissan van. In 3 months. Now, keep in mind, $1,500 for one tire. Keep that in mind. In 3 months, two tire bend in 3 months. So that's $3,000 that I had to take out from my pocket to buy tire, to run on the road that we're paying tax for when I go buy the pump. Keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. The damn road, when you break from one hole, is two things happen. Is that you break from one hole and you go down in the next hole, or you break from one hole and you hit somebody's vehicle? Clyde, you're talking nothing about that. So when my two tire bend now on the road that I paid a tax for by the gas station, by the pump, who buying back tire for me? Clyde buying back tire? Rohan Sinaran buying back tire? No. But when my tire cut one side now, from the same damn hole I hit, I hear this. You're going down the road. You go down in a pothole. Your alignment come out. You ain't have no money to buy back no tire again. You understand? Because the road's so bad, you hit a hole today, your alignment come out, you go tomorrow. You align it, you go back on the road, you hit a next hole again. And your alignment come out again. So when they say 50% of the vehicles on the road have tire cut in one side, Clyde, what are you going to do? You're going to charge the people for a defective tire and you're going to give them points on that. But you wouldn't go to damn Rohan Sinanan and tell Rohan, boy, you know the road bad, boy. But 50,000 people on the road who have a bad tire cutting one side, all they want to bust their throat with ticket, and all they want to bust their throat with the merit point. But what caused that, Clyde? I'm not hearing you. What caused the tire to cut bad? Which one? I don't have it. Now we're running this. imagine that Trinidad and Tobago. Tonight I decided to talk about it. The other day I see a police vehicle on social media. You can't even make out the number plates. The lights hanging down on one side. But when they stop you, also I can't make out your number plate and look your light hanging there, well, you go get a $5,000 ticket and you know you might get some demerit points. But the government had a vehicle running on the road anyhow. Clyde, what do you have to say about that? I putting you on the spot. You want to implement something to take advantage of the citizen? Not a problem. The citizen can't talk about it. They don't have a TV program. Hey, I go light it up. I go light it up. In 3 months' time, I spent $3,000 for two tires on my van. Two tires on my van. Twice I had to go and do alignment on the van. Twice. But Clyde wants to come out now and charge me now and give me the merit point now because my tire cut bad. It's the blasted road we have, Clyde. It's the blasted road we have. But common sense is like, oh, I don't have it. But then again, God really said, not much will have common sense. Many are called, but few are chosen. Not many have common sense. Let me tell you something. I waiting for a friend or a family to get some demerit points and their license disqualified. It's Clark and the magistrate and me and my lawyer and my friend. You want to see Bacchanal? Trust me. Because Clyde will have to come up with a damn good reason to tell the magistrate why the hell did my friend get the merit point. Meanwhile, telling all you. I don't feel afraid to talk. I ain't afraid to talk, you know. That is why I'm on television getting on like this. You know what? It's for the rights of the citizens of our country. Not everything or not every legislation and every law come out, you go abide, you know. Some is making total nonsense. Call him about implement. $5,000 penalty fee if only I go to pay the property tax while he bring out that legislation so he could be exempted. Make that make sense. Make that make sense. Any single time, a license officer stop me on the road and give me a demerit point system, so help my living God, you're getting, hear what you're getting. You're getting a summons to come to court. I will pay my ticket. But I want you as a license officer to explain to the magistrate the purpose of the demerit point system. You can't tell me a tire cutting bad caused me to get demerit point system to seize my license. You can't tell me a tint on a glass, I go get demerit point system. You don't know why the hell I had a tint on the glass. The bomb could have blown while I going to work. Make it make sense, Clyde. Tonight, I'm stinking you up because I can't call nobody else's name beside yours. If I could have called our next life officer for some name, I would have called it. But them is not the commissioner. So you, Clyde, you see just how you went and pull back up the video again. You see just how you went and sit down and you cross your foot and your confidence about yourself? Go on our next life program. And let Trinidad and Tobago know the reason for the merit point system. Because I go tell you something. When 10,000 drivers get disqualified for the merit point system and pay their ticket, let me see who family going to get robbed. Fix the road. Go to Rohan Sinanan. Talk to Rohan. Fix the road so we won't have bent tire. With confidence, you see how you sit down proper? That woman asks the wrong question. Take a look at this. Let me tell you something, Trinidad and Tobago. It's not easy, you know. It's not easy, you know. Anything that makes sense in Trinidad, I'm talking about it, you know. Look at that. When that caused your tire to get bent, and you had no money now, and you had to work your tire, and it cut in one-sided, ask Clyde if you know about them thing. I want Clyde to answer to that. Clyde, don't run and hide, you know. I got man, watch me. You ever want me start on your case, you know. They're quite telling you something. You ever want a man like me start on your case. You really aware of that? Because it have question I will ask you on national television. It have question I will ask you on national television. I one thing I don't play with. You see the citizens of this country and stupid legislation coming out and stupid laws coming out. So help my God, is a different story, Clyde. I'm gonna tell you something. I is not one of them who are all look at talk and they go shut them out, you know. No. It don't work like that. I share a video with a police vehicle. I'm gonna tell you something. The vehicle, police vehicle, the number plate, the man behind can't make it out. I try and take it back. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous, totally ridiculous. You think Clyde care about that? No, Clyde don't care about that. He ain't care about that. But what I want you to do, Clyde, is I want you to make a special appearance on any program, any talk show, and explain the purpose of the merit point system. Because so help my living God, anytime a friend or a family member get disqualified by the merit points, you go and explain to the magistrate what is the purpose of the demerit point. And don't tell me to keep the driver safe. Don't tell me to make sure the drivers them have good working vehicle. Don't tell me that. Don't tell me that at all, at all, at all. Because half of the government vehicle ain't working properly. Half of them ain't fit for the road. So putting you on the spotlight, you and your whole team. Now I want you to understand something, Trey Anthony. I want you to understand. I am not talking the licensing or the license office in Trinidad and Tobago. I'm not talking them bad. They have a job to do. They're doing it at the end of the day. At the end of the day. They had a roadblock to keep to make sure vehicles working good. They had a job to do. But you see the demerit point system? You see the demerit point system? What is the purpose of that? Because that system going and cause individuals to start a row. Yeah, did an accident take place on the highway. A case driver dead. We'll go on with that. We'll go on with that. Investigation still going on. We're going on with that. So Clyde, you have the whole weekend to think about the purpose of the demerit point system. Because let me tell you something. The demerit point system ain't causing nobody to drive safe. The demerit point system, it causing disqualified individuals to not drive on the road. Paula, good night.
Hi, good night, Saeed. Good night to your team there. Firstly, I just want to say Trinidad and Tobago, well, you ought to be real lucky that we have a soul like Saeed speaking out for the citizens. Now, Saeed, that situation you raised there with the blown bulb, let me put it into a practical sense. So, I wake up in the morning, I organizing for work, I start my vehicle, I put on all my lights, I walking around my vehicle, making sure every single bulb working. Nice, I jump inside the vehicle, and I heading out to work now, and I driving on deplorable roads that damaging my vehicle even more. So, dropping in pothole, my tire cutting, my suspension damaging, and my bulb blow, the amount of pothole are falling. I reach up now, before I could get to reach work, I get stopping a roadblock on the highway now. Licensing officer and police say, pull aside. They say, pull on the indicator. My indicator, one of the bulbs are working now, it blow. I have to get a ticket on the merit point for that. Before I leave for my house, I check it and it's working. How I supposed to know that it's working? I not driving from outside my vehicle, I'm driving from inside the vehicle.
All right.
And for those who may want to say, well, the light on the indicator go blink faster because you know that it go blink faster if a ball blow. Let me say, for example, if a brake light, or you go know, the thing is, the solution to this, you come now and you say, okay, we're making a note on the police system in the vehicle. The next time I see your vehicle on the road, if you don't change the bulb, then we will ticket you. That is the solution for that. Now, the laws and fines are very unreasonable. I want to touch on our next point quickly, that the TTPS vehicles are the most derelict vehicles on the roads, and many of them are doing the most lawlessness. You notice now that it is a trend. Police just be driving down the shoulder illegally and recklessly and bullying motorists to cut in and bullying motorists on the road.
Yeah.
That is nonsense. Look, the government is failing to maintain the roads. They can't even patch a pothole properly. They just take a pothole and turn it into a pot hump. Mm-hmm. Aside from that, that cable barriers there by Gasparillo, if those cable barriers were functioning, that woman in that accent, her life would have been spared today. She may have gotten some injuries, but the barriers would have saved her from crossing the median and crashing. When is somebody going to be held accountable for the mismanagement and corruption in this place? This is nonsense, Saeed. And we need more like you. We need the people of this country to rally around Saeed, because Saeed is a voice to the people. And Saeed, tomorrow is Eid. Happy Eid to you and your family and the staff. And I hope that God gives you all the blessings and powers to give you more strength to fight for the people of this country. Stay safe, my brother.
Thank you, my friend. So viewers, I just found the video with the police vehicle and the number plate that you can't make out. My staff go and download it and we're going to show it on TV. Hopefully, we get it in before we get caught. Call her, good night. Hello? Hello? You're sticky, get it click. Now, I'm going to tell you something. I have no problem against the license officer stopping the individuals, you know. You have a job to do to make sure that the vehicle is worthy for the road, no problem. No problem. But you can't tell me you want to give a truck man a ticket for overload. He's not the backhoe man. The truck can handle gauge. They say, well, you know what? I reach 100-pound weight. God, Clive, come on, make sense, man. Make sense, man. It's too long now. Too much of ridiculousness going on in the country. It's way above anything. Too long. A point system to disqualify a man who walking from 5 o'clock in the morning to 5 o'clock in the evening driving, you want to disqualify? But you know how hard the man walking to give a man a demerit point system to disqualify him? That is what I call creating ways for banditry. I telling all of that. My license good, you know. My license good. But I've been watching over the Easter weekend. And when I see what takes place over the weekend, I tell myself, I say, nah. Drivers can't be getting the merit point for a broken bulb. Drivers can't be getting the merit point for not wearing a seatbelt. Drivers cannot be getting the merit point because your windscreen tint. It's madness. It's total madness. If Rohan Sinanan would sit down and analyze this whole situation. Now I'm going to tell you this. From one driver being on the road with ticket upon ticket, you can make $100,000 with one driver. But think about one driver being suspended for 1 year. How much money are you making from that driver? Look at this police vehicle. Later on. Look at that police vehicle. Look at that. Watch out. Where Clive? Clive, I want you to see it. Look at it. They're stopping traffic and what's going on? And that government vehicle. But Clyde now can't want to implement that. I wonder if that driver getting the merit point system. I want to ask Clyde if a license officer will stop a police vehicle to give them a ticket. Come at him. Oh. The viewers, Clyde, you or anyone in your life stuff is not going to stop a police vehicle to get a man ticket. Come now, man, Clyde. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. So Trinidad and Tobago, I want to send Lord a happy belated birthday to Judy from Maxween. It's a place in Main Road in Princeton. So I want to send Lord a happy birthday to this woman. Let me tell you something. This woman always locked on my program. So I want to send a happy belated birthday to her. From her children and grandchildren, and of course, me, Saeed. The viewers, so Trinidad and Tobago, it was a pleasure being here. But Monday, I hope Clyde could come out and give me some answers. You know, it's Ramadan. Tomorrow, it's Ramadan. Tomorrow is Eid in Trinidad and Tobago. So, my Muslim brothers and sisters, I hope you have a wonderful day tomorrow. And may God give you the desires that you prayed for and fast for in the 30 days. So viewers, I have something nice here waiting for you to listen. But at the end of this song, our program will end. Until we meet again, good night.
مليني يشدو فمي والشوق يجري في دمي وإليك دوما أنتمي يا سيدي يا محمد قلبي المتيم كلما صلى عليك وسلم ذاق السعادة مغرما يا سيدي يا محمد.